ma'am, your press release actually mentions that there will be some amount of capacity addition when it comes to insulin, as well as you know, CAPEX plans. Can you tell us a little more about that, especially regarding the plant in Malaysia, and also a word on you know, your pipeline when it comes to biosimilars with Mylan?
Sure. So when it comes to our Malaysia facility, it's absolutely on track. But as I've shared with you in the past, the plant, both the drug product and drug substance plant, will only be fully operational in 2015. Up until then, we are very reliant on the India capacity and the India facility. But even there, we are trying to, you know, maximize capacity expansion as much as possible, both through productivity and balancing equipment that can actually give us a little more product capacity. Having said that, you know, you can see that our insulins business is gaining a lot of traction in emerging markets, and we are really hoping that, you know, with the Malaysia plant coming on stream in 2015, insulin should be able to then catch up with its demand. Right now, there is a gap. We are not able to cope with demand as much as we would like to. But having said that, that's a good problem to have, and we are trying to address it in the best possible way. When it comes to other CAPEX, I think we are looking at CAPEX injection in our research services business, because that also is looking to expand its base given the very interesting and attractive opportunities that are coming its way. Syngene today has an opportunity of transitioning from supply of clinical materials as a CMO to supply of commercial materials as a CMO, and this itself will be a big jump for Syngene, and we're looking at that kind of capital support, capital injection for Syngene over the next 5 years. Syngene alone will require about $100 million over the next 5 years, but I think this is a capital injection that Syngene can very well support. Biocon itself has a very strong net cash position of over 700 crores, and therefore, and knowing that the Malaysia facility funding is already in place, we feel that we are well provided in terms of all our capital CAPEX needs. So that's what I'd like to say in terms of our CAPEX proposals, our investment needs, and our business growth opportunities.
Ma'am, the last time we spoke, there was some holdup when it comes to approvals regarding oral insulin. Can you give us a few more updates as to what's really happening, and you know, any updates whatsoever when it comes to that particular drug?
Well, you know, as you know, there is a clinical hold in India because of the regulatory environment. So we have mitigated that particular risk by, you know, making sure that we can do this clinical development overseas. And that's the plan going forward. We are not waiting any longer for the India approval, which has, you know, held up some approvals for what we had intended to do in India, but I think we are making now plans to take this overseas. Having said that, we are still on track. So in terms of timelines, we are still on track to develop this asset along with BMS. But, you know, it was unfortunate that we could have done it probably a little earlier. But having said that, we just cannot do anything with the kind of regulatory environment that exists in India today in terms of clinical development.